I'm Cecil Robinson with the Oklahoma Game Development Blog, bringing you news and information on the local game development scene here in Oklahoma. And today I'd like to introduce you to two of our local developers and founders of Salamander Games.
Hi Cecil. My name is Josh Fry.
And I'm Chet Scott. We're both co-founders of Salamander Games. Basically in a small company though, you're really a jack of all trades, you know, designer, developer, pretty much anything that comes up. But if you want to know our official titles, I believe it's Pirate King and Ninja.
Yes, I believe that's right.
And how it's two particular professions that are kind of diametrically opposed to one that become friends and actually run a business together.
Well, we actually, we go a long way back. We're actually cousins. And so we've known, you know, we've known each other pretty much since Chad was zero and I was one. So, yeah. we have both been in Oklahoma City for quite some time since college. We both went to the University of Oklahoma, and have stuck around in Oklahoma City working in the technical profession. And we had an opportunity to both work at several companies together, and decided at that point that we wanted to try to pursue something that was a passion of ours, which is tabletop gaming, and see if we could create something new and interesting out of it.
So coming from that, with your family relation, how did you guys decide to get started with Salamander Games?
Well, I think about it, it really came from an initial spark of interest that we both had when we were much younger with tabletop gaming in general. We've both been into the hobby for quite some time. I think for us, it was probably the original Dungeons & Dragons that probably...
Yep. The old Red Box.
...dragged us into that, and obviously we've been fervent fans of gaming ever since, both tabletop and digital.
Pretty much out of the womb, you know. It's one thing that we tried to always do as a family. Mm-hmm. You know, even Grandma back in the day was always mm-hmm. wanting to play cards or, Monopoly, whatever. Just a way to get the family together, interact, and do something fun.
And this influenced the background as family, and family always playing games together. This influenced your design in your games as well?
Absolutely. One thing I know in trying to develop the latest one is making the game big enough to encompass, because when we get together, we all get together. So like a two-player game's not really what I'm looking to get out on the table. When we get together, it's, you know, 6 to 10 people kind of thing. So I want to get games where we can get more people around the table, and you know, you've got the interaction amongst everybody having a good time, cheering, booing, you know, cussing, spitting, whatever, you know, makes the game lively.
And that's really one of our design philosophies, is that one of the beauties of tabletop gaming is that you can engage people of all ages and at any interest in gaming. I fervently believe that nobody can honestly say that they don't play games. You just maybe haven't found the right game that sparks your interest.
And with such a booming board game community as well, what have you done to make Salamander Games stand out from all the rest?
Well, one of the things that we've tried to do is we've really tried to bring a lot of our own philosophies, what we enjoy in the hobby itself, into our designs. And one of those things, without a doubt, is making them family friendly. I think one of the things that Chad and I both find really appealing in a lot of the games that we play is that they're engaging on multiple levels to people of different ages. And part of that is because of where we are in life. You know, we both have kids, family life is important to us, and so being able to find games that you can play with your family and with other people who have family members is a great way to find something that you can sit down face to face and engage other people with and have a good time doing. And the game at that point is just it's kind of the glue that brings everybody together. So our game designs kind of reflect that. And certainly the game that we're bringing next to market is very much focused on being family accessible and easy to pick up and learn in a short amount of time.
And you can see that change just in the two games we've got out. Mm-hmm. You know, some areas that long campaign type, you know, you sit down and you play it for a whole afternoon, whereas all hands on deck is 15 to 30 minutes. Because, like you said, we got married, we got kids. Mm-hmm. Finding those times sometimes, mm-hmm. you know, can be tough to get everybody to sit down and play something for more than 15, 30 minutes.
Mm-hmm. There, can you please introduce us to All Hands on Deck, your newest game kicking off this September on Kickstarter?
Well, sure. All Hands on Deck is a pirate-themed card game, and it's for 2 to 6 players. And game time runs anywhere between 15 and 30 minutes. The basic theme behind the game is that all the players are pirate captains who've been out battling each other at sea in an extended sea campaign, and you've made your way back to port to take on for repairs and replace the crew that you lost during your last battle. As you make your way down to the local CD Pirate Tavern, you discover that several of the other pirate captains have had the same need and designs, and they're there at the tavern with you, and you suddenly find yourself immersed in a bidding war for the best and the most capable sailors that that are available. The game itself is centered around kind of a rummy style game with an auction mechanic. The idea is that you're trying to be the first player to build a consecutive run of 7 cards in one of the 3 suits, or a consecutive run of 3 cards in each of the 3 suits. So there's kind of variable win conditions to the game. But this is accomplished through a round-oriented auction where everybody bids on a card that's out in the center of the table, and it's a blind bidding process. So you're bidding the cards in your hand that you don't want to keep, and trying to win at auction the cards that come up that you do want to be able to build the hand that you need to collect your set and win the game. Now, to make the game a little bit more competitive and backstabby, because we all like, you know, how backstabby pirates are, there's also a mixture of action cards in the game that allow you to influence the auction, steal things from each other and do that kind of thing, and really just create another layer of player engagement that makes it just that much more fun.
And when creating this game, was there anything that you wanted to try to put in at first that wound up being left on the cutting room floor?
We had not, as far as the action cards went, that's where we made a lot of changes. We had ideas for other action cards that, as we tested it, they just didn't work right. You know, there was one called the Black Spot, but it didn't have the same feel as the other cards, so we had to end up cutting it. There were others that just didn't play well, or they were too powerful, or they were honestly just kind of useless cards. You know, it's a one-trick pony, you really wouldn't use it that much. So there was a lot of ebb and flow with the action cards to get them right, get the right flavor, get the right interaction amongst the players.
And when you were playtesting, did you do this amongst yourself or to the greater board game community?
We did it wherever we could. I mean, you start with your peer group, you know, just the two of us playing, family, friends playing, just to get the first few, you know, make sure this is a decent idea. And then we start expanding out from there, going to the game stores, sitting them off, you know, going to conventions, into the, the unpub areas, getting people to try it out, play test there, give us some feedback, doing the blind play testing, sending some off to people with just the rules, and here you go, let us know what you think. That's where you get the best feedback, by the way.
And it's that kind of play testing. When you put it on a project, it's arduous to have to do, but it pays off in the end, because you really do start to see where your potential issues are, and you know, it's all about trying to focus that in before you call the product done and put it out on the market.
And as always, you gotta take the good with the bad. You know, if you get the same comment 10 times, okay, that's something you need to look at. But if there's one guy that says, you know what, there aren't any, Godzilla needs to be in this. Well, no, it doesn't.
Or pirates are stupid.
Right. But you also have to have thick skin, you know, be able to take constructive criticism and not, you know, go roll up in a ball and cry in the corner just because someone says they don't like your game.
And I take it amongst the gaming community, you already have fans of your works who are planning to, pretty much just waiting for you to open gates to the Kickstarter to put their funding in already, or already spreading word about Salamander Games for you?
Well, I know you are. So we got at least one.
Right. And my wife likes it, so that's two. So, but no. The secret to the Kickstarter and Indiegogo and the other crowdfunding sites is you have to build that crowd to get crowdfunded. And certainly one of the things that we've done for the last year and a half or so, as we've kind of been in the play testing and final design development stages of this game, is we've been trying to to go out there and find that crowd. And as we mentioned a little bit ago, part of that is getting it out to conventions, showing it off to people, building our social media footprint, and trying to be as visible as we can be out there before our campaign, so that once our campaign goes live, we already have people that are interested in it, and will help us have that initial push that'll hopefully get us to success.
All right. And if anybody else wants to learn more about your upcoming game, All Hands on Deck, or about Salamander Games in general, where can they find you at?
Good.
Well, certainly you can find us on our webpage, which is www.salamandergames.com. We have information out there about our company. This particular product, All Hands on Deck, which is coming to Kickstarter in September, and also some information on future projects that we're working on now. You can also find us on Twitter at Play Salamander, on Facebook at Salamander Games, mm-hmm. and
I think that covers.
There's probably some men's room walls that our information's written on. So,
Chad, Josh, thanks for joining us, and for you guys out there, thanks for joining us as well. And if you would like to have more information about the local game development scene here in Oklahoma, just go ahead and head on over to the Oklahoma Game Development blog at OKGameDev.com. Until then, we'll see you later.